Well, I come to you bearing horrible news. So if you wanted good news, I guess you came to the wrong place. And cue the fire! Vlad, why are you so mad? And it looks like we have a possibility, a probability of a historic collapse. And not just that, today I actually watched a little bit of that stuff that you guys called news. So if you think that I am doom and gloom for a millisecond, you really need to watch what's on TV. And I will roll that clip for you in just a second, but before I do that, I just want you to know life is about probabilities. And our brain just wants to go black or white, right or wrong. But I'll tell you, life is about probabilities. And if I were to tell you, hey, you know that Dogecoin? That thing's going to go from nothing to a trillion or whatever it was. Or that they're going to lock you down. No, that'll never happen. Or maybe Russia will actually fire nukes. Oh, no, that will never happen. See, everything will never happen until it does. So cueing the nuclear warhead is a probability in life. Would you not say? You getting into a car accident and dying, that is a probability. That is exactly why you have car insurance. Or if you don't, I will leave a link in the description. And I am joking. Actually, doesn't Meet Kevin sell life insurance or something? A little outside a sandbox, I would say. Actually, funny thing is, my wife's walking by. Hey, babe, didn't you just took out life insurance policy on me? Why is that? And why are you laughing? Why?
I need money.
You need money from what?
In case you die.
Am I gonna die?
No.
Okay. So the good news is it looks like I'm probably not gonna die. Wait, hold on. How much did you take out on me?
10 million.
That's all I'm worth, 10 million. Okay. But real quick, let's look at this clip. Sorry, I turned my audio up. You may want to turn yours up a little. It's only 5 seconds. Here's the news.
All I will say is that if Russia attacks, fires upon, takes a shot at NATO territory, the NATO alliance would respond to that.
It's been a very busy.
Okay, one shot. That actually sounds like an Eminem song, but not in the right narrative. Moscow. This is Putin. We will put USA in its place. Vlad, so mad. And again, I just bring probabilities. Is there a probability here that he could go push buttons and go down into a bunker? I say yes. If you say no, you're in what's called denial. So when I trade stocks, when I do anything, I say there is a probability to the upside, probability to the downside. We just trade based on probabilities. How many nuclear weapons does Russia have? What to know about Putin's arsenal? And now, is there a probability if you have almost 5,000, 3,000 plus 1,000, so 4,500. I don't care if it's one, plus the subs that are all over the place. Is there a probability that some one dude's gonna go, oh, push the button? I mean, when you back a rat into a corner and they're like, well, you know what? Might as well just go out with a bang, call it a day from Washington Times, not Russian Times. Russia could win World War III. Oh, that's a great article. In Europe with EMP nuclear attack. Basically what they're saying, if you get first strike, you win. Now, I am not going to say that this is going to happen. I will, though, say there's a probability. If someone is standing in front of you with a gun, okay, and that said gun is loaded, there is a probability. Would you not agree? Putin reveals existence of nuclear command bunker, a very large bunker underneath mountains, including... Do you get it? There's probabilities here. I mean, I remember just a few weeks ago where my audience was like, Russia, I'm like, okay, Russia's going all over Ukraine. I think they're going to go in. And you guys, not all of you, but you're like, no, it's not going to happen. This is what they're doing. It's kind of like America protecting its borders. They're not going to go in. I'm like, but there's a probability. Would you not agree? And you guys are like, no probability. And then you traded all in on the ruble, which ended up being the rubble. And it's the same mindset that people have that like Bitcoin's going to a trillion, quadrillion, a bazillion, all in. Or the whole world's going to end. I'm just going to have gold. That's it. You walk into your house, all you see is gold. Which I say, congratulations. That is something good to hold. I like holding money. It's nice. It sits there. It's money. Doesn't really do much, but it's money. Congratulations. It should protect your wealth. Oh, we got a breaking news. Stock making the biggest moves. Hey, I think I'll take advantage of that. Thank you very much. Russia claims to have ordered crucial bond payment as it seeks to avoid historic debt default. And then when I show people this, they're like, oh, that'll never happen. No, there is a probability that they will default, that Putin will get very mad, start pushing buttons. The Kremlin staring down the prospect of its first foreign currency debt default in more than a century. And what people need to understand is if you take out debt in the dollar, which that's what the world keeps doing, and what people don't understand is the debt that's outside of the United States is actually bigger than what's inside the United States, the euro dollar. So when I say, hey, the euro dollar curve, or it inverted, the yield curve on the euro dollar inverted. And every time it does that, do you know what happens? We go into a recession. Just like we had an inversion of the yield curve, we had, what was it? Let me give you the other 12 things. Oil prices, 50%. There is a probability of a 99.9% chance that we are going into a severe recession. And then the question I have for you, have you prepared? Are you ready for it? Do you have all of your accounts set up to profit from said recession? And also, just in case you wanted to know what performs well in a recession, that would be nothing above my head. No, don't say that, Bravo. Bitcoin performed very well in a recession. And let me turn on a little indicator to show you how well Bitcoin performed in a recession. That's the green bar. I'll go over a few things with you. Also, you're stuck in this range. I'm not trading this. This is not... This range, not until it goes this way or it goes that way. So you got to break either, what are we looking at, 38.9 or 44. And then let me point out two other things for you. Number one, high, okay, lower high. Let's come over here. That's a high, right? That's a lower high. Lower high, lower high. Let me just tell you, when it hits that, it's going to cut through that area right there like butter. But the good news, with two fingers, there is a lot of money to be made off of this trade. When it happens, kind of like that gold trade that we were talking about for about a year. When it breaks this, it's going either way up there or it's going to go way down there. Also, this week, I am raising the price of my Crypto Stocks University course to match my swing trading course. So grab it now, link in the description before the price goes up. That's if you want to understand technicals. See this, how I carried this measured move, and this is exactly what's going to happen. It may not play out exactly to the pixel, but it will, either that way or that way. We just have to wait on it. I don't know. And also, I have one more probability for you. If you are not doing anything, you will make no money. Guaranteed. Well, we are talking paper trading. If you are invested in this paper trading, there is a high probability that you will make money. But there is also a high probability that you will make absolutely nothing and get wrecked. If you just leave your stuff sitting in a savings account, you will actually lose money. Depending on how you want to look at inflation, what are you guys down? 20% on the year? Also, it's interesting looking at this gray, the green area, that's your recession zone for Bitcoin. If you want to know, right prior to entering it, you want to know how much you lost? It doesn't look like that much. You're like, that's not, that barely even moved. Yeah, you lost 56% of your money, or you got ready on the other side. And let's take a look at the bond market, which is total garbage. I would totally agree with you. 100% trash, but that trash made 22%. In a recession, that's only if you clicked the sell button. You have to take profit. So when you see me making long-term plays, there is reasons for that. And if I were to go back, do you see? Recession, what happened? And I'll tell you absolutely nothing if you did not take profit. If you did not click the sell button, if you did, that was 35%. Also, just to let you know, everyone thinks I am crazy. Why are you going long bond? What are you, nuts? The Fed's is raising rates and you're doing it now. You got crystal balls of glass. One small pebble will break those. Moving back, let's see, what else? Well, that's all we got. I got one for you. Restoration Hardware. This actually follows the housing market. How's your housing market doing? Really good right now. Well, Restoration Hardware is telling you it's not gonna. Or how about the Dow? Not too good. How about the SPY? Oh, not too good. How about QQQ? That's the technology sector. Not too good. Well, I'm sure we must have performed better in 08. Nope. We still lost our pants. From peak to trough, just in case you wanted to know. You know how we had a peak and then we haven't hit the recession yet. We will. You just wait. Down 53%, but then we have reversal. Yay! And I will be closing one position and taking out a new one. And then everyone's confused. They're like, Why are you doing this? For some reason, people just are like, you're like Peter Schiff, forever gold. Like, that's it. That's all we do. So all we do on this channel is just buy gold, which actually I think only about 10% of his portfolio is gold. Poor guy. Kind of like my buddy Kevin over there. If you've met him, I actually have his portfolio and I'm sure he's changed, right? Over the last year, maybe. How's it doing over the last year? Yeah, that's not too good. Yeah, that's not too good. How's that one? Nope. How about this one? Nope. This one? Nope. And this one? I'm going to say nope. But it's okay because we all get to go through trials in our life. We fall down, we get up, we learn our lessons, and then we change. Hopefully we do, right? You've learned some things along the way. Going back to my main story, bond coupon payment paid? Huh? Yeah, we heard that about Evergrande. Nope. Russia's bond payment is in limbo as countdown to default begins. I say cue the fire once again. How many moves does this kid have left? I mean, is there going to be another payment that's due? You know, like credit card? Like, okay, so we will take all these credit cards and we'll put them against that card. Okay. And then when that bill comes, we'll go ahead and take out more loan, which that's what they already did in the US dollar because rates were so low. But now they're moving up. Oh my gosh, wait, where'd I put my credit card? And then back to the story of could someone push the button? How desperate Putin has. He has three moves left against the Ukraine. And he is running out of time. So I know they're saying that they made it, but we will just have to wait and see. But again, you're gonna have more to pay. Also, the other payment of my course is going up. So please grab it now so you're not emailing me. Please, can I have it cheaper? And I will see you in the next video.